Hello students, welcome back to the class. So last class we have discussed about the definition of nation, nationality, nationalism, introduction. In this class we will continue the topic. Okay, so in this class we will discuss about the definitions. Okay, the different author has given different decisions about definitions about the nation. So we will discuss about all the authors and definitions and all. Okay, so first one, if you see that the quest of national hegemony have mainly inspired by millions of peoples. So first one, okay, the quest of national hegemony have greatly inspired millions of people. Most of the people, as soon as when they are living together, a sentiment will develop, and that sentiment is called as nationalism. Already we have discussed nationalism is one type of sentiment. So national is a sentiment which is mainly developed among the group of peoples. Okay, the group of people which are living in the community. So this sentiment have inspired millions and millions of peoples. Okay, because of that sentiment only many people can able to achieve independence, and many people can able to achieve the national state. So national states can able to form because of this sentiment, because many peoples were inspired. Okay, most of the peoples were greatly inspired. Most of the people were greatly inspired by the feeling of nation. Okay, so this is one part. Next, come to the point here. Every modern states, when we are talking, every modern state is a welfare state. And this welfare state is a dominant of societal organization. So every modern state is a every modern state is a national state challenge. Okay, in this next point, most of the modern state is a national state. Modernization cannot be achieved without nationalism. This is also a very important point. If you wanted to achieve the modernization is possible only because of nationalism. So modernization is possible only due to the nationalism. If there is no modernization, the national state cannot be achieved. And that is the reason for every modern state. If you see, whatever the states which are going towards modernization, modern states, every modern state, this concept of nationalism is very important. And this is why it is very important, because this national states plays a very important role for dominating the societal organizations. In social organizations we can find different type of organizations which you can find in society. So this organization was mainly created because of the nation states. So every modern state is a nation state, and nation states are very important for the organizations which are formed in the society. There are different type of organization which are formed in the society. What is the common thing in this organization is groups. Okay, people, most of the people which have a common feeling, so they will form a particular organizations. So the main idea is, if they have a feeling of nationalism, then that responsible for the formations of social groups. So that is one point. Next, if you see that the word, now if you talk about the meaning, the nation is nothing but a meaning which is originated from the Latin word natio, which means birth. Okay, nation state means the person from where it birth. Wherever if you are taking birth, that state can be called as nation state, birthplace. Okay, most of the places which are related to the birth, that state can be, that country can be called as nation state. So the word nation is originated from the Latin word. Okay, already we have discussed. So this is the first word which is originated. This is mainly belongs to Latin, is a language which is mainly comes from the Italy. Okay, in this language the word nation is derived, which is called as natio. Okay, the word nation is nothing but this derived from the word which is called as natio, which means birth. Okay, people who are related to a birthplace, for them that is called as national state. Okay, if you wanted to be the citizen, okay, national state, every national states can able to provide responsibility. Every national state can give the citizenship of the person. Citizenship of the person mainly describes the nation state. how can you relate that state, how can you say that that is a nation state? So in nation state we can find birth, wherever the person is taking birth, okay, for him that state will be the nation state. Okay, normally if you are taking birth, okay, if you are taking birth in any nation, okay, that state can be a nation state for you. Okay, the place of birth is very, very important. Okay, now next come to the point. In modern time this concept is very significant and very, very important. In modern time the concept of nation state is very, very significant and very important. Okay, a feeling of birth. So whenever if you are taking birth in the country, then you will get a feeling of nationalism automatically, and that's why the word nation is originated from the Latin word natio, which means birth. Okay, whenever the people are taking birth, okay, whenever the people are taking birth in any nation, for that state can be called as national state. Okay, feeling of oneness, feeling of togetherness. Okay, so this feeling can able to develop the sentiment of nationalism. One is feeling of oneness, feeling of my nation. If you get a feeling of my nation, when you will get that feeling of my nation, so these types of feeling when you will get means when you are taking birth in the nation, then you will get feeling of my nation. And when you will get the feeling of my nation and feeling of oneness, then normally the sentiment of nation also will form. So this is one point. So national sentiment is very important in every modern time. In modern time, in the sense in the present time, the concept is very, very important. Okay, next come to the point, Barker. So different authors has given different decisions. For example, Calvo, Barker, Lord Byron, Burgess and Stephen Leacock. So these are the different authors has given different decisions regarding the nation state. So Calvo have written one international book. Okay, he have written an international book which have greatly emphasized, okay, which is giving more importance to the idea of nation. Okay, idea of nation. So idea of nation mainly depends upon the birth and community of language. This is very, very important. Okay, these two concept is very, very important. So Calvo have written one of the famous book which is called International Law. So he have written a work, okay, he have written his work, written work, and he named that work as International Law. So in this what he have explained, he mainly concentrated upon the idea of nation. So in this law, in whatever the book we have written, International Law, in this law he have mainly given importance to the idea of national state. National states can be related with the two concepts. One is the places which should be related with the birth, and the community which are having a common language. Community of language is also very, very important. Language can play a very important role. This is also one element of nation, okay, which will bring together people. So nation is one type of element which can bring together to the different type of peoples. Togetherness, a feeling of togetherness, that concept is also called as national state. So Calvo in his book, he wanted to explain and he wanted to concentrate, and he has given more importance about the idea of nation, in which he have given, okay, two ideas are very important for the nation. One is birth and community of language. Okay, that is one point. So and these two things can play the very important role. Okay, these two can play the very important role for increasing the feeling of nationalism. Okay, that is one point. Now next come to the point, Barker. Barker have written, what is meant by nation? Nation is nothing but what? Okay, different author has given different decisions about nation. So previous Calvo have given a decision that the idea of nations are mainly related to the birth and community of language. Whenever the people are related with the birthplace, and whenever the people are sharing the common language in the community, so that is mainly associated with nation. That state can be called as nation. Okay, so this is one point. Now Barker has made a decision, and he has given a definition about nation. Is nation is nothing but a body of person, okay, group of people. So nation is nothing but a group of people who are living, inhabiting is nothing but the place which you have been occupied, that is called inhabiting. So whatever the places which have been occupied, that is called as inhabiting. So here Barker has given a definition about the nation. Is every nation is nothing but a body of person which are being inhabiting, okay, which has been inhabiting a territory, and which are being most of the people who are living in the territories are being united, and they are living and they are facing and they are sharing common land. So whatever the group of people who are living for a many years, many long years they are living and they have occupied a territory, who are living in a group, who are sharing some common ideas, so that state can be called as nation state. So this idea and this definition was given by Barker. So what Barker has given, a state can be called as nation state when a body of people are being inhabited or occupied any territory. Okay, they are occupying a territory. In that territory, when the group of people are living united and the people are living and they are living in the common land, so that is called as nation state. They are sharing some common, yeah. Now Lord Byron has given one decision. What is called nation state? Nation state is nothing but a nationality is very important, and nationality should be organized, and this nationality will be organized by the political body desiring to achieve independence. So nationality is, most of the nationalistic feeling when we got, most of the feeling when we got when we are fighting independence challenges. Whenever if you are fighting for independence, then this types of nationalistic feeling is very very important. Okay, take an example, India. When we are fighting for the independence, then you know we have formed one political organization, and this political organization is nothing but we have formed one political organization which is called INC, Indian National Congress Party. Okay, so for every national state and to increase the national sentiment, first political organization is very important, and after formation of political organization, mainly the importance of nationalism is to achieve independence. Okay, so here also he has given decisions, definitions like Lord Byron. He has given a decision about nation, that every nation state nationality is very very important, and this nationality is very important for organizing the political body. So this nationality, if you have a feeling of nationality, then you will form a political body, and these political bodies are very important, and that main desire for the political body is to achieve independence. So every nationality, what is the concept of nationality, is to achieve the independence. Okay, before also if you see that before independence, what I've said, before independence we have formed one political organization which is called as Indian National Congress. This organization is mainly responsible for and what is the aim of this organization during that time? The main aim of Indian National Congress Party, which was formed in 1885, already we have, means you know, 1885 this was formed, and the main aim of this organization is to achieve independence. Every political organization, when it is fighting with the foreign rule, the main role is to achieve independence. So he has given one beautiful decision, Lord Byron. In nation, every to achieve the nation state, nationality concept is very important, and this nationality is very important for the formation of a political group. The main aim of political group and the desire for the political group is to achieve independence. This is one point. Next, we'll go forward. Burgess. Burgess has given different decision. He is given different definition about nation. Nation is a population. Nation is nothing but the people who are living in the ethnic unity, who are living in a, who are living for a many long years, who are living in the territory, who have occupied territory, and which are mainly responsible for geographical unity. Okay. So different decisions has given. Decisions has given in a different way. So he has given a decision that every nation states are nothing but the population which are sharing the common language, common religion, common culture, ethnic unity. When these populations are sharing the ethnicity, when they are occupying a particular territory, when they are living together, when they are sharing a geographical unity, so that is called as nation state. Okay, India is the best example we can find. India is the best example of nation state. In every nation state, common thing is very very important. Okay, common points are very very important for everything. So here Burgess has given a definition about the nation state. Every nation state is nothing but the population of the places which are sharing the common ethnic unity and which are inhabiting or which are living in the particular territory. And when these common states are sharing the common geographical unity, then that state can be called as national state. Geographical unity is very important. Nationalism is very important. Okay, when we are talking about nationalism, is very important for achieving independence and also for development of the country. The concept is very very important. Okay, next we'll talk forward. Stephenson, Leacock, has decided. Stephens and Lukoff have given a decision about nation. Nation is nothing but the body of people. Okay, nation is nothing but a body of people which are united and which are distant and sharing some common language. So here we can find Stephenson has given a definition about nation state. How can you call this state as nation state is nothing but in every state when the body of people are living, when a group of people are living together and this group of people are united, these groups of people are getting united by descent and common language. So that state can be called as nation state. Okay, so this is one point. So Stephenson, Lukoff has given a decision about the nation state. Okay, he has given a decision about nation state is nothing but a body of people and a group of people which are united and which are sharing some common distance and some common language. So in this point we have discussed about how the different authors has given different decisions, what is the meaning of nation state, different authors has given different decisions, we have discussed in the topic. Okay, so thank you children, we will meet you in the next class. In the next class we will discuss about the element of nationalism. Okay, thank you very much.